So you're relocating to Joint Base Lewis McChord. You want to live about 30 minutes away, maybe 45, and you have no idea where to go. You don't know if you should go north, south, east, or west. I'm going to unpack what it's like to live within 30 to 45 minutes of Joint Base Lewis McChord. So a lot of these areas are totally different from each other, even though they're so close. So we got to talk about what you want out of the place you're going to live in. What's it like? What's the town going to be like? Because it's all a bunch of small towns surrounding Joint Base Lewis McChord. So for instance, did you grow up on land? You know, do you want an acre or 5 acres or something like that? Because there's areas where you're definitely not going to get that unless you get really lucky or you spend a lot of money. Or on the flip side, do you prefer to have some neighbors around you? Do you want to be in a tight-knit community with other people around where you have walking trails and things like that and local stores? We're going to talk about that too. So I'm going to take you on a tour and we're going to map out from north, east, west, south, all the way down. I'm going to tell you what it's like to live in these little areas so you have an idea of maybe how you fit. So we're going to start with the areas that are closest to the main gate at JBLM. So here you're going to have DuPont, mostly. You're also going to have Steilacoom, which is close to the water. And then you're going to have Lakewood and University Place. So all of those kind of cluster really close to the main gate. And even these four little spots are all totally different from each other. So DuPont is a lot of the times people's 1A. It is a master planned community. There's a lot of porches. It was all kind of designed from the start. So walkable with front porches, trails. And the difference with this is though, if you do not want to live with a bunch of people right next to you, it is very much a subdivision. So where it definitely has its strengths, it also has maybe its weaknesses. If you want some land and you don't want to be around people so closely. So a lot of people want to live in Steilacoom. Steilacoom is the oldest incorporated city. It's a really cool place. It's a lot of retirees. The properties, most of them were built quite a while ago. So it's definitely older than DuPont. And the prices are a little bit higher. I've personally found in the market where now, it's a little bit hard to get into. So people may start their search there for a home and then they may end up somewhere else just because of the lack of options. So Lakewood is gonna be a little older construction on some of the homes. It's gonna be definitely more affordable than the other two. And to the north of that is gonna be University Place. What University Place is known for is really the schools. But it can be challenging to get into and the prices are gonna be a little bit higher. So moving north, we have Tacoma. And if you don't know anything about Tacoma, there's Central Tacoma, there's Proctor District in Tacoma. There's a lot of different places in Tacoma, so we have to get a little specific. Overall, what you're gonna deal with is there's gonna be more density, there's gonna be more rooftops, and there's gonna be more traffic. So we don't have enough time to go into the specifics of Tacoma on this video, so do your research. So we covered west and we covered north. Now let's cover the east. So on that west side, the closest thing is gonna be East Gate, as far as the gates go. The closest city is gonna be Spanaway, and then you're gonna run into Puyallup and Graham. So this side also bears some similarities to the other side. Affordability is gonna be most high in Spanaway. Land is gonna be most plentiful as you move out to Graham. And then a lot of people are gonna chase Puyallup specifically for the school districts. So again, Spanaway is gonna be the easiest to get to, most affordable. Puyallup, you're gonna have a little more traffic. There's a couple of ways around it, but the main thoroughfare is called Meridian and it definitely piles up. And so you're gonna wanna consider that too with your travel time to post, but you're definitely gonna be inside of that window of about a half an hour. And if the traffic's ideal, it may even be closer to 10 to 20 minutes. So again, as you move out, the affordability of the homes is gonna get better. So if you're out in Graham, even south of that in Eatonville, if you want some property, that's definitely gonna be the place you're gonna wanna look. So your other alternative when going into Eastgate is gonna be kind of directly to the south. And that's gonna take you into Roy and the town of Yelm. So if you're wanting to maximize your potential amount of land, this is typically what I see. The type of person who says, hey, I want a little space, but I still want to go into Eastgate and I want my commute to be as short as possible. I'm going to tell them, hey, let's check out Roy, because that's going to be the easiest spot. And directly to the south of that, Yelm, pretty close, still going to get you there. It's just going to take a little more time, but overall, it's kind of the same feel. So here's what you're going to want to know about those areas, specifically Yelm, is it's like its own little town because it's not really that close to I-5. And on the other side, it's not really close to the areas that bring you to like the shopping centers and the malls and things in Puyallup, movie theater, whatever. The good thing about Yelm is it does have all those things right in its own little town. It's just if you're gonna wanna go to Olympia, or you're gonna wanna go to Puyallup, or you're gonna wanna go to Seattle, you're kinda in a little spot down there that you're gonna have to go around to get to those places. But if you like that small town feel, if you are used to growing up in a small town, and on some land, Yelm is going to be definitely a spot you're going to want to consider. And the houses, because they are down there kind of by themselves, are more affordable for sure. So this brings us to the south, but then over to the west, and it brings us to Lacey, Olympia, and Tumwater. So these areas cover a lot of ground, a lot of different styles of housing, plenty to choose from. And if you're going to be going into Main Gate and you don't want to be in DuPont or up north, this is definitely going to be the spot you're going to. So if you're chasing kind of the most affordable home prices, it's going to take you further down to Tumwater. And if you don't care about that, you can be anywhere in that Olympia Lacey area. And what you want to know is Lacey is just a really small spot on the inside of Olympia. So the thing to know about the Olympia Lacey area as opposed to on the other side or up to the north is just that the overall the housing prices are going to be a little bit less and you're going to have direct access to I-5. Also, what's different about it is there's a lot of water. You're directly near the Sound, so you have access to some places. If you do want a view of the water, if there's a chance you wanted to buy near saltwater, you're going to be right there, right with all the inlets and everything like that. So there's a lot of little other small towns. If there's any questions you have, if you're doing your homework, you want to know what those places are like, I know the place like the back of my hand. So feel free to reach out to me, and also be sure if you want to know more about some specific neighborhoods in Thurston County in Olympia, we did a video on that. You can check that out too.